One of the most successful traders of all times is Paul Tudor Jones, who started his own firm at the age of 26 and then started trading cotton at the pits. He produced 28 straight years of wins. One of his best known predictions is the one of the Black Monday in 1987, when the stock market crashed 22% in a single day. At the time, most people saw their investments go down the drain. Paul Tudor and his clients made 60% return in this single month and 200% for the whole year. In this video, I want to share the top 7 trading strategies from Paul Tudor Jones. Hi, my name is Mehmet Kara and my channel is all about investing. If you are new here, consider subscribing. If you are already subscribed, welcome back. The first lesson from Paul Tudor Jones was the topic of one of my most successful videos. You can check it here. The rule is simple: never bet against the trend, or in his own words, you always want to be with whatever the predominant trend is. The most important metrics to look at here is the 200-day moving average. I have explained this greatly in my video, so I won't go into details right now. The second rule: don't be a hero, don't have an ego, always question your ability, and don't ever feel that you are very good. The second you do, you are dead. If you want to be a successful trader, you have to forget about your ego. As soon as you feel that you have everything under control, you are going to screw everything up very soon. Simply because you can never be in full control of the stock market. The only thing that is in your own control is your reactions and your feelings on the changes in the market. This is the only thing in your circle of influence. Lesson number 3. There is no school, no training that can teach you how to trade, whether it's the end of a bear market or the end of a boom market. There are a lot of places where you can learn about the stock market. My channel is one of the places where you can do. But with all the hard work that I put to find the best materials and to present them here, the best teacher is the market himself. No matter how good have you prepared yourself to anticipate every move in the market, there will be for sure many surprises that you didn't see coming. The only thing you can be meticulous about is to control your own trades. Always have your trading plan. I have talked about the trading diary in one of my previous videos. So always have your move ready, especially the exit plan, and get ready to get out of your position even if you are losing before the things get worse. This leads us to the next rule, which is, according to Paul Tudor Jones, the most important rule. The most important rule is to play the defense, not the offense. Most beginning traders are anxious to trade all the time. They keep looking for potential good trades and enter them way too soon. And they don't have a real trading plan before trading. So beginner traders are doing just the offense. They are not thinking about the defense side of the things. While the most pro traders play the most of the time the defense. They know there will be and there are right now a lot of opportunities in the market. So there is no need to rush into a trade without having your exit plan ready. Instead, the first thing you should do is to have your trading plan ready and be ready to exit when things don't go in your way. Also, never risk too much capital because you don't know how the market can surprise you. Lesson number 5. Learn to fail. Because, as Paul Tudor Jones says, failure is a part of my life. Have you ever failed in anything? I bet you did. A lot of time we do it, actually, especially in our trading journey. But the good thing about doing mistakes is that we have run into a territory that we shouldn't be there. Now, the key thing is to learn from mistakes and to avoid them in the future. By learning from your mistakes, you can improve yourself and grow into your future. Lesson number 6 is about the favorite topic of women: size. After a while, size means nothing. It doesn't matter if you trade $10,000 or $1,000,000. The trading strategy is the same. Although, if you're honest, for most of us, there will be never a time where we can say, does it really make a difference to trade with $100 million or with a smaller sum. But the key takeaway here is the following. Your trading strategy doesn't get influenced by your account size. You should always have a clear strategy and follow your trading plan. Also, your position sizing should be roughly the same, percentage-wise that is. That's one of the great things about trading, that you can start with a really small amount and still get the feeling about the trading and strategies which are involved. Lesson number 7, the last one. But here I shall say that I have 7 more lessons for you and there will be a second part of this video. So lesson number 7 is the favorite one of me. At the end of the day, don't forget that your job is as simple as buying low and selling high. That's it. It doesn't get any harder than this. In order to be a successful trader, you have to buy stocks that are going to increase in the price and sell them in the future when they are more expensive. But also, you can short stocks which are going down in the price. So that way, you can short them at the high price and then buy back at the lower price for more quantity of these stocks. And really, we shouldn't make the things more complex than they are actually. Understand that this is your main objective. Now you have to look at stocks or maybe crypto coins which are going up in price and buy them, sell them at a higher price, or identify stocks and coins which are going down in price, short sell them and buy back at a lower price for more quantity. As I said, this video is going to continue. Now I want to hear your opinion. Let me know which one of these quotes is your favorite one. Do you find any value added? And if so, press the like button. See you again with one of my next videos.